Hi there. My name is Matthew White, and I'm the new CEO at the Victoria Symphony. I'm honored to be part of the team, and I look forward to working for such a vital and internationally well-respected organization. Before asking our music director, Christian Kluxen, to answer a few questions, I thought it was worth reminding people that despite the constraints of the pandemic, the Victoria Symphony's mission remains the same. We are passionately committed to enriching lives through the shared experience of extraordinary music, and we look forward to finding new and innovative ways to deliver on that mission over the coming months. Now, Christian, it's wonderful to see you. I know that the orchestra misses you terribly. Is there any message that you would like to share with them and with our audience about the upcoming virtual season?
Thank you, Matthew, for inviting me to do this interview. The very special message that I want to send to both our musicians and our audience is that I miss you also very, very, very much. It's very, very difficult times for all of us, but I sincerely hope that I can return to Victoria rather sooner than later.
How have you gone about choosing the repertoire for this virtual season? Are there any highlights you'd like to share with us?
Well, of course, there are many factors to consider when we make a virtual season like this, which I can talk about a bit later. But at this time, it's very uncertain exactly what we will present during the whole season. So I think the highlight itself will be that we are actually connecting with our audience again through this virtual season. So what I would say to you about searching for the highlights of the season, don't look at it as a normal season in that sense. Rather think that every virtual concert that we share with you is in itself a highlight. So what I would do if I were you is just stay tuned and see what we are coming up with.
So assuming things don't change again, what can people expect in terms of frequency and the type of concert programming between now and January?
Well, the first concert we will present will be Vivaldi's Four Seasons, with our very own Terence Tam as concertmaster and leader. And this concert will be recorded at the UVic Farqua Center, and where you will be able to experience the orchestra physically distanced on stage. After that, we want to present a couple of times a month several different programs in several different venues that you are all familiar with in Victoria. And I think it will be a really, really exciting thing to connect with us like that. We are determined to make this one of the most innovative and successful virtual seasons in Canada. So I think you can expect very high quality, and I'm looking extremely forward to seeing you for the first concert, which is will be sent on October 1st at 7:30.
So I can imagine that the pandemic poses some pretty unique circumstances. What are some of the challenges specific to programming at the moment?
Well, there are many, many challenges programming a season that is a virtual season. One of the problems for me is that I can't be with my orchestra. And I have to be honest to you and say that this is a big sorrow for me, that I cannot feel my orchestra and make music with them. Of course, there are other things that are also problematic during this pandemic programming. There are, for example, certain regulations in venues that we have to serve, and we will want to make sure that everyone is safe while making music.
So can you tell us a little bit about what it's like to make programming decisions when the rules on the ground continue to change on an almost minute-to-minute basis? It seems like one moment we have to regard a flute as a dangerous weapon, and another it's just a flute again. So what is that like?
We have to be flexible. We have to be flexible with the number of musicians on stage. We have to be flexible in the way that they are physically distanced on stage. We have to be aware how we get the audience into the hall while still being safe, and we also have to think about what type of music is still, although it's a virtual season, developing and exciting, not just for the orchestra but also for our wonderful audience.
So I don't think there are many people that believe that the virtual platform is ever going to replace live music making. But I would love to know what you think are the benefits to these online concerts, and what is different? What do they bring that is special to enjoying a concert experience?
I mean, technology and digital ways of connecting with audiences have developed incredibly during the last couple of years, and gives us a special flexibility in ways to connect with the audience. So in that sense, it gives us a special opportunity to actually ironically get the audience closer to the orchestra and our musicians on stage. I think you will all probably find it as a very intimate experience.
This is an elephant in the room question. Will these concerts be free to the public, and how are we going to pay for it?
Well, you're touching on a quite difficult point, of course, because we are dependent on our tickets and our donors. But actually, because of our donors and because of government partners, we are actually offering all these concerts for free, which is a big privilege. But it's very important for us to tell the Victoria audience and our community that we are so happy to be your orchestra, and that we have been your orchestra for 80 years, and we really want to honor that through offering this accessibility through virtual concerts. That being said, though, we are still depending on your support, and therefore I would really ask you to at each of these concerts maybe make a tax deductible donation instead of purchasing tickets. It will really go a long way for this organization to survive and to bring you music also after this pandemic.
Thank you, Christian, for joining me, and I look forward to connecting with you further over the coming weeks. Thank you as well to the broader Victoria Symphony community, and I encourage you to stay connected via our website, social media, and our e-newsletters. I look forward to seeing you all on October 1st.